Hey everybody, welcome to the production of Filtration and Martingales, a basic explanation for the Armbrsuter Academy. Okay, here's an outline of what we're going to talk about today. First, we're going to go through the basic concept of sigma fields, and then building on that, we'll talk about filtrations, and finally we'll talk about martingales and give some examples. Alright, sigma fields. Now we can talk about sigma fields in the setting of a probability space. And sigma field is basically a set of measurable events. And you ask, what exactly does a set of measurable events look like? Well, it can take a lot of forms, but here's a nice little sigma field with a set of measurable events from a counting process. And this is just a general example. All right. Now, since we can only talk about events in a sigma field, sometimes we might want to make multiple sigma fields. Well, in this case, we make a sigma field G that tracks odd and evens. Now, filtrations. Filtration can simply be described as a sequence of sigma fields, where we have information that gets updated over time, and we see that script F1 is contained in script F2. And that's contained in script F3, and we can go further for generality all the way to script Fn. Now we could touch on the definition of a natural filtration. If we have some stochastic process, Xn, the natural filtration is a filtration that has no alterations and contains all the information from the process thus far. X naught all the way to Xn. Alright, now we're ready to talk about martingales. First, we should highlight on the concept of adaptation. And what adaptation is let's say we have a process Z and we have some filtration F. If the sigma field of Zn is contained in the filtration F, then it's considered being adapted to it. We touch on this only because when we're talking about martingales, we always talk about some filtration. So adapting to filtrations is an important concept. Now, here's a picture below is a martingale, and I'll present an intuitive definition that you can tell from the picture. A martingale is a process where the expectation of the process, given the filtration, or in other words, the information from the past, is just where the expectation is just the current value of the process. All right, now here's a formal definition of martingales. We also make the addition of supermartingale and submartingale. A supermartingale is when the expected value of the process is less than the current value of the process. And a submartingale is when the expected value of the process is greater than the current value of the process. Okay, now we present a nice example that covers the aforementioned definitions. Consider a gambler that can win or lose a dollar based on the coin flip, and the coin may be biased. Well, when the probability is 1/2, then we have a martingale, and expected value is 0. It's not expected to win or lose. When we have a probability of less than 1/2, the expected value of the process is going to be less than the current value of the process, and we have a supermartingale. Finally, when the probability is greater than 1/2, the expected value of the process is going to be greater than the current value of the process. So we have a submartingale. Alright, that wraps it up for martingales and filtrations. I hope you enjoyed the talk, and please listen to other talks in the Armbrsuter Academy. Thank you.